Hello to all, welcome to Electronics. I'm back with another video. In this video, I'll be showing how we can interface 7 segment displays to an Arduino board. I have with me here a 3 digit 7 segment display board and an Arduino UNO board to which I'll be connecting the display. Working with 7 segment displays is not that difficult. We will need 8 pins of the microcontroller to send data to the display and few more pins based on how many digits there are on the display. With me I have a 3 digit display, so I will need 3 more pins to control them. So in total I will need 11 digital pins of the Arduino board. On Arduino UNO board there are 14 digital pins on the right side of the board, which is sufficient for this project. The bottom 2 pins on the right, that is pin 0 and pin 1, are TX and RX, which are connected to USB wire to program the board. So I'll use pins from pin 2 to pin 12 for connecting the display. I want to use an 8-bit jumper wire to connect data line to the display, but there is a small gap in between the pins here. So I'll use 2 4-pin jumper wires and use the top 4 here and the bottom 4 here for the data. And the bottom 2 pins and the top 1 pin, that is pin number 2, 3 and pin number 12, to control the digits. Now let me just quickly do the connections. I'm using a common anode display, so I have to connect the power pin of the display to 5V, which is available on the Arduino board. Now all the required connections are done. Now let's start with writing the code. Now to start with programming, let's start with bare minimum. Bare minimum gives us these two functions where we can start writing our code. First, we have to initialize the pins we are using as output. So in the setup function, we can initialize all the digital pins we are using as output. So I'll just write a for loop which will initialize all the pins one by one. That'll be from pin number 2 all the way up to pin 12 as output. If you have used different microcontrollers before, you may find this way of initializing pins as output a little bit different, because with other microcontrollers you can just write a byte level command to some port and you can initialize all the 8 pins at once as input or output. Let's say you're using 8051 microcontrollers, you can just write 0x00 to the respective port and it will initialize all the pins of the port as output at once. But in Arduino you can only initialize pins one by one, so if you want to initialize a pin as input or output, you have to do it individually, so we cannot at once initialize all the pins. Hence we have to use a for loop. Next, apart from 8 data pins, I'm using 3 pins to control the digits. Let's call them D1, D2 and D3, connected at pin number 2, 3 and pin number 12. Also we need 3 more variables to hold the value of 3 digits that are being displayed. Let them be A, B and C, and let the initial value be 0. And all these 3 variables will be 1 byte each. Initially I want all the 3 digits to be off. Since I am using a common anode display with an PNP transistor controlling on and off of the display, so writing a high on the pin will turn off the transistor, hence turning off the display. So we are done with the initializing part. Now once this part of the code gets executed, all the pins will be initialized as output and our display will be off. Now I want to display numbers from 0 all the way to 999 and keep rolling over. In order to accomplish this, we can just increment the value of the three variables that are holding the value of three digits. A is the first digit, so if the first digit reaches the value of 9, we have to reset it and increase the value of next digit. And when the second digit goes above 9, we have to reset it and we have to increment the value of third digit. And similarly, if the third digit value goes above 9, which will happen at 999, we just have to reset its value to 0. Now, since we are using same data bus to display on all three digits, we have to turn on and off all three digits in sequence. We will turn on the first digit by writing low to it and keep the other two digits off, and send the data of the first digit on the data bus. Next, I can copy and paste this and turn off the first digit, turn on the second digit, and send the data of the second digit on the data bus. And finally, I can paste this once more, turn off the first two digits and turn on the last digit and send the data on the data bus for the third digit. Now, this technique is called multiplexing. Now you can see that when the first digit is on, we send the data to display on the first digit, and when the second digit is on, we send the data to display on the second digit, and when the third digit is on, we send the data for the third digit. And after displaying each digit, we can wait for at least 5 milliseconds. Now, when the code executes on the display, we will not see the switching that is happening between first, second and third digit, because the delay between the switching is only 5 milliseconds. And anything that is blinking faster than 25 milliseconds, our eyes see them as continuous. So in total, these three digits will be blinking within the time frame of 15 milliseconds. But since 15 milliseconds is less than 25 milliseconds, we will not be able to see the switching. And this part of the code will be increasing the value of all three digits one by one. I want the counter value to increment on the display with a delay of 0.5 seconds. That is, the value should go from 1 to 2 and 2 to 3 with a 0.5 second delay. Now, if I just add a delay here for 0.5 seconds, what will happen is the value of the counter will increase, but for 0.5 seconds the display will be off. And this will be a problem in this loop if we try to achieve the delay this way. But we want this part of the code to be running continuously. So what we can do is we can achieve the delay of 0.5 seconds using this part of the code. We can just enclose this part of the code in a loop and run it multiple times. Since there is a combined delay of 3 times 5 milliseconds, that is 15 milliseconds in this part of the code. So what we can do is repeat for 500 millisecond delay, we can repeat this part of the code 33 times and we'll get a delay of 0.5 seconds. So I think we are almost done with the code. Last, we have to write this send data function. We can write it after this loop. Now, in send data function, we want to write the code to display the number on the respective digits. But we cannot directly send the numbers 0, 1, 2, or 3 to the respective pins of the display. In order to understand this, we can look at how 7-segment displays are designed. 7-segment displays consist of 7 segments of line LEDs, which when turned on in a particular way can display any number you want. Turn on and off these LEDs, the respective pins are brought out on top and bottom. And all these LEDs are labeled from A to G and the dot as H. And the respective pins are also labeled from A to H. So in order to turn on any particular LED, we have to send a binary 0 to the respective pins. So let's say if we want to display a 1 on the display, we have to turn on the segments B and C. So we have to write a binary 0 on the pins B and C and binary 1 on all the other pins. This will give you a 8-bit binary code which looks something like this. So similarly, we can generate a binary code for all the numbers which I have already generated, and I will just copy and paste it. This array, which is called segment code, holds the binary values of the respective numbers from 0 to 9 and the alphabets A to F. Now to send the data to the particular line, first we have to get the segment code of the number which we want to display. Now in Arduino, we cannot send a byte directly to all the pins. So what we have to do is get individual bits in sequence one by one and then send those bits one by one to the respective pins, which will start from pin number 4 all the way up to pin number 12. And at last, I just have to initialize all the variables we have used in this function. Now I think the code is totally done. Let's upload and see how it looks. Now when I first uploaded the code to the microcontroller, it was displaying something weird, maybe in alien language. But after going through the code, I realized that the segment code array was for common cathode display and not for common anode display. That means all the zeros in these bytes have to be reversed to 1 and all the 1s have to be reversed to zeros. So in order to achieve that, we can just add an inverting sign in front of the segment code. And then I re-uploaded this. And now you can see that it is displaying everything properly. We can make this count go faster by changing the value by reducing the delay. We can reduce this number to 20. And upload it. Now you can see that it is running a little bit faster. We can make it even faster by reducing the delay. And now you can see that it is running much faster. So that's it for this project. I hope you found this explanation and this project helpful. In my next project, I will be using a temperature sensor and displaying the current temperature on this display. So I will be using this 7-segment display with this same code and connect a temperature sensor on the analog pin and display the temperature value on the 7-segment display. So watch out for that video, and when I upload that video, I will leave a link in the description. So see you in my next video with a new project.